2019 Radio Personality of the Year winner, Stephen Phillips.
You paying attention to this, Packy?
And as long as Pat Malone is already out of bed,
then I might as well ride herd around here.
Well, giddy up.
And Packy Smith is still special, too.
You guys know these demo tapes don't just edit themselves together, right?
Well, all right.
Three cheers for Stephen Phillips.
Y'all need to help Stephen Phillips out over there. Out the door and off the radio.
Here's Stephen Phillips.
All righty, folks. We're walking into the room, passing out dollar bills. Good morning, everybody. How are you, Pat?
I'm good, Stephen. How you doing, buddy?
Man, this is the day, the day, the day. We got Wednesday, which is Gary Chapman, singer-songwriter. Then Friday, the day that takes us out, always takes us out with the Undertaker.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning.
Good. You can do better than that. Sound a little more chipper.
Good morning.
Good evening.
Yeah. You're not at work today. You don't have to say, good evening. Yeah. How are you feeling?
Welcome to Bannister Cooper. Make your 7-0.
Oh.
Wow.
Hey, Pat, how long do you think Stan Gunner's going to take to figure out that I swapped his tag on the back of his car for mine? That SRA tag.
I need one of them.
Yeah.
Can't you not? They don't write them tickets, don't
you? You can park anywhere with those.
Pretty much.
and you can go 100 miles an hour on the freeway.
Yeah. How come we all can't have one of them?
Because you probably don't need that.
I need that.
Because you didn't have the intestinal fortitude to cast your hat in the ring and run for public office.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. If he's running 100 miles an hour down the interstate, I'll probably pass him.
Yeah.
Plus, plus everybody else on the interstate, too. Yeah.
Super speeder.
Yeah, I mean, what is the average speed now on the interstate? 120?
Feels like it.
I mean, honestly.
We have a caller.
Hello.
We have Perry this morning.
Hey, Perry, good morning. Where are you calling from?
Brasstown.
Brasstown, the heart of America, right there. Brasstown, North Carolina, world famous possum drop. What are you doing up so early?
I've been up since 3:30.
Uh-oh, you can't sleep?
I go to bed early and I get up early.
Yeah, me too. What's bothering you this morning?
Yesterday you said the crime rate in Venezuela was down 67%.
That's what they said.
You know why? I do.
Okay, tell us.
Because all of them's up here, all the criminals.
That's true.
Well, you do have a point, no doubt. Yeah, you got a point. Let them come through.
I just want to let you know that's why those crime rates are dropping down there.
Well, that makes good sense, good sense. So what are you doing today anyway?
I'm a loafer. I'm retired.
I love it, don't you?
What
kind of, you're from Brasstown. I just want to know what kind of work you did, or can we talk about that in public?
I worked at Miller Welding for 40 years.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty cool.
I was the one that brought you those tomatoes our last year.
Oh, yeah. Man, I'm telling you, hey, you know, the mater season's coming back, and I welcome all the maters I can get, brother.
Yeah, I'm getting ready.
There you go. I think we're going to have to get this big garden, because we definitely ain't going to be able to buy it from Ingles.
No, everything's ridiculous, and I don't know why people don't realize the cause of it.
Well, now, what is the cause of it? I'm trying to tell Pat Malone, what is the cause of this?
He's got a name. It's Joe Biden.
Ah! Listen, Eddie, what's Pat?
I agree.
Okay.
He is.
Okay. All right, we got an agreement. Yeah. All right, man. Bring me some maters.
All right. See you, Steve.
All right, bud. Yeah, all the Venezuelans up here, because our crime rate's up, 6,000%?
Something like that.
Yeah, 6,000.
That happens when you try to defund the police and all the other craziness that's going on.
You know, you learn something new every day, and this totally blowed my mind. But I was out there actually trying to be nice to Harry as I could be. It's, you know, it's hard.
Now, wait a minute. Your nose is growing, buddy.
Well, I was.
You are never nice to Harry.
Well, I call
passive aggressive.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
You know, he has a rape whistle. He carries a rape whistle. He threatened to blow his rape whistle. I mean, that's just weird. A dude with a rape whistle?
I'm not touching
him. Holy smoke.
That's awful.
Package like,
yeah, you're on your own on that one too.
Yeah.
Package like, well, what's so odd about that? I got one too.
Speaking of,
never had to use it.
You got it just in case. Yeah.
Speaking of Packy, if you don't trust the government to regulate AI, what would you propose in its place?
Okay, back up. So I was texting Pat during the show,
right?
Because they were talking about. So Stan was on there talking about what the government's going to do about the AI thing, right? So, you know, they can basically, you know, make an AI, like they say, of, you know, like a politician saying something, and well, that's misinformation. Is that what y'all are saying, basically, Pat? You can make somebody say something, and they're not really saying it, and it looks like they're saying it. So like you said, the feds aren't doing anything, but the state of Georgia is trying to do something, right? So they'll have, like, a little label on the bottom, so, like, made by AI, right?
Right.
Right.
Following you so far?
I'm with you.
Okay, yeah. So what if California does it, and it doesn't have a little thing on there that says made by AI? Does that make it true?
That's the problem with doing a patchwork
So now let me ask you this. Give me another example where the government did something and it worked out.
That's what I'm thinking. You want the government.
So you've said it yourself, Pat. I mean, like, you know, why? Oh, the government doesn't do anything right. They break everything they touch and blah, 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 blah. But then this time it's going to be different.
Yeah.
Well, now.
And it's always different this time.
If you go back to the Constitution and understand the Constitution and the role of the federal government, one of the areas that they've been very successful in is national defense.
Up till now.
Well, yeah, it's still.
So they've been successful in national defense. Is that why we have an invasion of 15 million people coming into our country? Mm. That's probably the biggest national security threat that we've had. They've done a terrible job.
That's not the Department of Defense's area of responsibility.
Where was the Department of Defense in the Constitution?
It's in the ability to defend the country.
But so is the border control.
Well, you know, let's go back.
Separate
the two. They've done a good job. We've never been invaded, right?
Well, we're being invaded right now, Pat. We have 15 million people across the border.
It's immigration.
Yes.
It's not a war. It's not a.
Let's go back
conflict.
To the
military agency.
Hold on a minute. Let's go back to the AI thing you were talking about. So they're trying to pass a thing that you have to have a thing at the bottom of this. It says generated by AI.
Right.
Okay. So that's about like.
State of Georgia. Right, Pat?
Okay, but that's like the gun control. Okay, we're going to take up everybody's guns. But only illegals will keep their guns. You see what I'm saying? So people that make these things, that's a watermark. I mean, it'd be simple to take
off. That's an excellent point. Because, like, the people who – because it doesn't – like, you don't have to have, like, OpenAI make it for you. ChatGPT make it for you. I mean, it's not – you can do it yourself. I mean, you can use high-powered processing chips.
Ain't nothing to it.
That's exactly the problem that they're having and why they didn't come to some kind of regulation.
Y'all didn't talk about that. Y'all didn't really talk about that. You didn't really talk about the specifics. That's why I was asking you the question, and that's why you brought this up, because if you don't trust the government to do it, that's why I don't trust the government to do it, because they're not going to do a good job. They're going to make it worse.
My point in asking you that was simply to understand what the hell would you do in its place. I mean, I hear all your complaints, but I never hear you give me a solution.
I know, but your alternative is like, we have to do something, so let's just freak out and do something.
Yeah,
you know, like,
knee-jerk.
Yeah, knee-jerk reactions.
What would you do?
I don't know.
It sounds like you would do nothing.
If I didn't have a good idea, I would develop a
program that could identify that, and I'm sure they could probably do that. That'd be pretty simple. You'd look like, okay, this is AI. But you don't got to worry anything because, you know, people that generate the AI, and if they don't put the watermark in it, I'm sure that the Department of Justice will bust them. I mean, you've seen them work with the cocaine they found in the White House, so it shouldn't be no problem with that. I feel confident. I think everything will be all right.
Same thing goes for you. Quit complaining and tell me what the solution is.
Okay, here, you want my solution, Pat? Really?
Yeah.
My solution is that you develop an alternative that verifies if something is human-created content rather than making something that finds out if it is AI-generated content. So if you're going to have a sharing platform, you ask my solution.
Regulation.
No, I'm not.
I'm for the private sector doing it. Who would do that development?
The private sector, just like they're doing the AI.
Right.
Like the private sector, the people who are developing AI develop a program to do this, but one of them says, but I'm going to get my stuff through.
Is there money is there money to be made?
There you go.
It?
If somebody could come up with something to identify this with some kind of computer generated that can identify that it's AI, man, they'd be making money. It's all money generated. Yeah. And they could do that. Yeah. I mean, it'd be simple. I mean, they got all kinds of stuff, you know, that they can do. And I know Tamla's like, let's do the death penalty because
no,
business
I'm not.
Comes in.
Wow. It probably already exists. But like Becky was saying, they're not going to. They're not going to limit their own stuff, what they want out there. So,
I don't know. I think some of this stuff's hilarious. Y'all seen some of that with Biden? Oh, my Lord. It is hilarious. You know, they got him dancing in prison. It looked just like him.
But where do you? But where would you draw the line on stuff like that, though? I mean, at what point can they just say, oh, that's AI, or that's not real, or, you know, that's misinformation? They've been trying to do the whole misinformation thing, fact-checking things. And the federal government. I mean, did you not read the Twitter files? Oh, you didn't read that either.
So what is the issue? What is everybody worried about the AI? What is the main issue with this?
Making politicians look bad.
False information is spread.
So what are we going to do about CNN, MSNBC? Should we not start there before we get to this AI stuff? Should we not start with that first? If they're worried about misinformation, let's start at the top.
Your opinion, that therein lies the problem. You think that's false information.
Well, I guess it's just, does anybody else think the MSNBC and CNN's pretty much?
Sure, all your buddies, everybody that's on your side thinks that. But that's not half the world.
Pretty much.
The other half of the world sees CNN as a news source.
I know, that's where you get your news source from, and look what we get into.
No, don't.
Well, Pat, you just made our point for us because, you know, some people, half the country's going to think this way, half the country's going to think this way, but the federal government can't sit there and say, well, that's misinformation, and that's not misinformation.
Right. I don't want
because
that's
censorship. And it's the same people I saying, like, you're a book ban, and you're going to ban all of our books, and you're taking the books out of the schools, but you got to label everything misinformation because it says something that's against vaccines or something like that.
I'm
you know?
All right with taking some of them books
once
out
again,
of school.
We got a problem without a solution.
Yeah, so like if you have a problem, doesn't have a solution, don't write a law.
That's
my point. Don't write a law about it if you don't know what the heck you're doing.
The solution is now do nothing.
Exactly, for the government. Okay. And 90% of the time, I said 99% of the time probably, if the government didn't do anything, it probably would be better. Because give me an example of something that they actually fixed.
Here's the thing they're worried about Pat. The whole nine yards, they're worried about misinformation, which 90% of it's not. I mean, after 2 or 3 months, you figure out, well, it really was true. I mean, with all this stuff going on in the world,
it's true.
I don't care if they put anything out there. I mean, who's going to waste their time on me and you?
They were censoring things about the COVID coming from a lab in China. They had stuff on there.
You don't care if people say things. And yet, if anybody says anything about Trump, you go ballistic.
I don't care. As long as people talk about me, they talk about me behind my back. Don't tell me up front because I don't want to hear it. You know what I'm saying? Just talk about me behind my back. I'm cool with that.
Change the subject.
Well, I get aggravated with truth and non-truth.
But the point is, the government is not the arbiter of truth. Like, they should not be. Like, I mean, like I was saying, that when the whole COVID thing was going on, COVID did come from a lab in China. It came from a lab in China, and they were putting things on Facebook saying, no, it did not come from China. This is misinformation. It came from a market, from a bat, and all this stuff. They were putting that on the little things on the bottom. This is exactly what we're talking about. And it comes to find out that it did come from a lab in China. It was a man-made virus, and they had been telling people that it wasn't the whole time. And if you go back and look at the Twitter files, the FBI was telling the people at Twitter what to and what not to put on there as misinformation.
Right.
Hey, just so you know.
They've even a lawsuit going on with Google right now where they actually held down information about all that stuff.
I mean, it would have never came to light unless Elon Musk had bought it and just opened up that information. He didn't change anything. He just said, hey, here, this is the Twitter files. This is what your government was doing with your tax dollars.
There you go. All right, we got to get to a break, and we got Miss Tamla Cooper here from Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, the only funeral home. When they give you a bill, it says, thank you, and please come again. Take us away.
No, it definitely does not. All right. So today's show is from...
I guess they don't have return customers, do they?
Wow. Even Packy's on me today. All right, today's show is brought to you by Bannister Cooper Funeral Home. We would love to get your wishes down in writing so that your family does not have to do that while they are trying to grieve your loss. So give us a call, 706-896-2218.
And now with more news for Western North Carolina and North Georgia, I'm Jeff Batten. It's been longer than Dina Gooch has been in Union County GOP politics since the party has organized a candidate forum. But the local chairman thought the timing this year seemed right.
Well, really, this is the first time we've had some really good competition within the Republican Party. We're just excited to be able to have choices.
Gooch and her party will host an event Tuesday for the three local Republican candidates in the sheriff's race and the two candidates in the county commissioner's race. She says the event was planned before the two Board of Education candidates and the two state rep candidates could become involved. However, she adds that representatives from their campaigns will be there stumping too. Gooch thinks property taxes are on the minds of the voters for the commissioner's race, even as Union's millage rate still rests within the bottom 10 counties statewide. She thinks questions about the parks and rec budgets will be addressed, along with roads and infrastructure. In the sheriff's race, she predicts questions will be raised addressing the effects of illegal immigration on the county. And while she allows that outgoing Sheriff Mac Mason has been a popular sheriff, she thinks his hand-picked replacement, Sean Dyer, still faces competition from Tom Jones and Doug Lloyd.
I've told these guys, run your own campaign. It's you that's out there. I think Mac has done a really good job. You can always have someone that comes along that can do a better job than he did.
The event Tuesday is from 6 to 8:30 at the Union County High School Fine Arts Center. She expects a crowd of several hundred. The doors open at 5:30 p.m. For Pat Malone and Harry Bond, I'm Jeff Batten.
Hi, this is Marvin Cooper with Bannister Cooper Funeral Home. At our funeral home, you won't want to ask for the man in charge. All I do is write the checks. My wife, Tamala, is the funeral professional, but I am good with finance and can tell you, in this time of high inflation, there is no better time to pre-plan a funeral. Gas prices are up, food prices are up, even dog food prices are up. Come lock in your funeral or cremation price today. We are Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, Towns County's local funeral home.
If you've been injured, you don't need to go to Atlanta or Gainesville to find a lawyer. The Law Office of Daniel Duello specializes in accident cases and is based in Blairsville. I used to defend insurance companies and saw their attempts to pay less through pressure and delays. Now I want to use that experience to help you get treated fairly. Just search for Daniel Duello or call 706-603-3036 and I'll see you in Blairsville. It's 706-603-3036.
The chicken continues to cross the road in Hiawassee for the best breakfast anywhere. And it's best not to make them angry. Locals know the best homemade gravy, biscuits, and yeah, chicken are right down the street at the Angry Chicken Restaurant on Highway 76 in the Chateauguay Place Shopping Center. Find the best daily menu at the Angry Chicken. Locally owned with veteran and first responder discounts. Facebook the Angry Chicken Hiawassee for hours and daily specials. Takeout, catering, and now trivia on Friday nights.
Kitchen remodelers, what are those three wonderful words again?
Granite, quartz, and marble.
Exactly. See them all in one Young Harris showroom. Introducing Masterpiece Granite, right here in the Enchanted Valley. Stop by and make your selection from the best names in the industry.
New countertops arrive within a week. Go to MasterpieceGraniteLLC.com to see the samples for yourself.
Or Masterpiece Granite LLC on social media. 441 Plot Town Road in Young Harris. 678-677-4974.
The easiest way to turn your day into a win is with the two sizzling beef patties and two melty American cheese slices of the double cheeseburger. With a mix and match deal at McDonald's, I can pair my delicious double cheeseburger with a 6-piece chicken McNuggets or small fries. Choose two for just $3.89. I can even add a medium frozen Coke for just $1.99. For me, it's a double cheese for the dub. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Single item at regular price. Coca-Cola is a registered trademark of the Coca-Cola Company.
Blue Ridge Mountain EMC recently completed fiber optics internet construction in a large area of Union County. Members on Town Creek School Road, Richard Russell Scenic Highway, Liberty Church Road, Arkaqua Road, Track Rock Gap Road, Stevens Road, Bald Mountain Creek Road, Jack's Gap, Fane Branch, Crump Creek, Low Gap, and Old Sullivan Road are now able to get fiber optics internet service through Blue Ridge Mountain EMC. Get the mountain's fastest and most reliable internet service now by calling 706-379-3121.
Fridays on the Dish are presented by Bannister Cooper Funeral Home in Hiawassee. The experts at Bannister Cooper will guide you through the important family conversations when it comes to making end-of-life arrangements for a loved one. Yes, we're Towns County's funeral home, but we're welcome to all. And now, back to the Morning Dish.
All righty, folks, we're back with you. Hope everybody's doing good. We're sitting in here with Miss Tamla from Bannister Cooper Funeral Home. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Yeah, anything exciting going on in the world of, see, what is it you're on, the Downtown Development Authority?
It is.
How's that going?
It's going well right now. We are, you know, just working through, getting ready for our concert that's coming up. So we did the concert over at the Ridges last year. It's going to be held at the Georgia Mountain Fairgrounds this year. Mm-hmm. So we're just kind of preparing for that. And of
What's it for?
It's a fundraiser. So people who want to donate money to, you know, there are Paris buildings.
You going to donate to that, Stephen?
The Paris buildings?
Yeah, I was
going to. How much more money y'all need on that thing? How much more money y'all need on that thing? Like $2.5 million already.
All of our projects. So I was trying to find the little flyer because off the top of my head, I was telling Puddin why you guys were gone.
What other projects are y'all doing?
Other projects?
Yeah, you said you had projects.
We always have something going on. Right now, that is our main focus, though.
Right.
You know, we have the Shook House that, you know, we're trying to get somebody into. And, you know, there's always something kind of going on there. But right now, that's our main focus. So we're having a
So 80s. When is that thing supposed to be done?
I've heard September now. So supposed to be finished complete. September was having a conversation with somebody about that just the other day. So, but our fundraiser is in July. It's mm-hmm. July 20th. We are going to hold it up there at the fairgrounds. And so it's $450 if you want a VIP table, or general admission is $30 to get in. And it's going to be 80s music this year. Last year we did a Jimmy Buffett theme. This year it's going to be 80s music. So,
hey, I seen the thing on Facebook. I don't... True Youngblood is playing some kind of a benefit. Y'all, he just recently got signed. We had him on here, young kid. I don't remember who it was. But anyway, True Youngblood's going to be playing. I like to see
that's
that.
That's a fundraiser for the sheriff.
For Henderson, right?
Oh, is that what it is?
I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
I think that little old fella's going to do good. I really do. I mean, I hope he does.
They asked you to play first, but, you know, you just didn't have time. So
well, yeah, they thought it'd be, you know, they don't want me to show up at a fundraiser.
Yeah, they'd raise too much money.
Sticky fingers, you know what I'm saying? They don't let me take up the offering at church anymore.
I didn't see that. So he's going to be doing like...
Oh, I didn't know, but I guess that's what it is. Huh. Yeah.
Interesting.
And talking about music, man, this is mind-blowing to me, man, because Kiss has sold its music catalog and the face paint designs to ABBA. How about that? ABBA.
No, it's to ABBA Hologram Company.
ABBA. Same thing. Sometimes I feel like rock and roll. I mean, can you imagine ABBA dressed up like Kiss? I guess that's what they're doing now, right? They're taking over Kiss, and ABBA's going to be Kiss now, and they'll be doing... Sometimes I want to rock and roll.
Listen, all of the different all the different music genres that are like crossing right now. We've got like rappers doing some country stuff, and was it like Beyonce did Jolene? Did she really?
I hadn't heard it yet.
Yeah, I haven't either. But she did another country song, and I was like,
"No, she didn't."
What is that?
She did a whole country album, Country and Carter, or
a
something.
Whole album. So there's like 8 or 9 songs out there with her.
You know, country and bluegrass, though, like if you listen to covers of songs, usually if it's a bluegrass or country cover of any whatever song it is, it's usually pretty good. You know, you could take a lot of songs, but if you try to take a country song and make it a rap song or anything like that, it never sounds good the other way. But pretty much any genre, you could make it a country song or a bluegrass song. It's going to sound cool. AC/DC, Thunderstruck, you've heard that before.
Yeah.
Those guys doing that.
Interesting.
I'm not, you know, I like you fellas that like bluegrass, but you know how I feel about that. You hear one bluegrass song, you heard them both.
Oh, two of them.
I don't know, man. I just think Beyonce, I don't, everybody, you know, we even had Steven Tyler went in there and did a country album. But, you know, I mean, you know, you don't redo Dolly's song, except for that one drunk chick that did it that time. But
oh yeah,
she did a fantastic job. And everybody was mad. Everybody was mad at her. She was like,
you know what,
so disrespectful because she was drunk on stage. And I'm thinking, there's not a musician out there that has not been in her shoes.
And Dolly was so classy about it.
She's she don't care.
Yeah, she kind of laughed it off.
Yeah, she don't care at all. But, yeah, I don't know. I can't wait to hear ABBA's new cut of AC/DC. That ought to be.
Should be great.
Yeah.
Bob M., he's commenting on there. Are you sure this whole show isn't generated by AI? Better ask Jeff Batten.
That was not nice.
No,
Bob M. is secretly Harry Bond.
Oh, goodness.
Harry's got a rape whistle.
What? Bob M. is the voice of reason.
Well, no. It says you, it also underneath there says you have a good laugh on Fridays also. Good day.
There you go. Yeah. We ain't got Tommy here today. Has Tommy got this? He's got to change his goat yoga day.
That next comment is absolutely, we need to read that. It says, good morning. Good, what? Good morning, guys. And young lady, young. Hey, I have big news. Did you hear about my big news that does not make me feel young?
No.
I'm going to be a grandma.
Really?
Yes.
Granny?
Yes. I don't care what the baby calls me. I am so excited.
Well, that's congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's kind of a life-changing thing right there. There's no doubt.
We were not sure that we would ever get grandchildren, so
right.
You know, we were super excited.
That's awesome.
So our daughter is going to have us a baby.
So is
excited.
They're gonna call you granny or what?
I don't care what they call me. Yeah. They call me grandma, granny, nanny. All I care is that we're having a sweet, precious little baby.
Well, I'm a papaw.
Papaw.
Yeah. You look like a papaw.
What do your grandkids call you there, Pat?
Gamper.
Aw, see?
Camper?
Gamper.
Oh, Gamper.
Yeah.
Camper.
Devin, my grandson, when he was a baby, that's the first thing he called me.
Gamper.
He couldn't get out Gamper.
See?
Well, that works. That's cute.
I think the baby will decide what they call us.
They do that.
We just don't even care.
Yeah.
We're just
Emily's
excited.
Mimi, because all the nieces and nephews that come before was always Mimi because of Emily.
Mimi and Papaw.
Papaw, I'm a Papaw.
Pawpaw, Papaw.
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 Pawpaw's up north with them Yankees. They don't know how to say Papaw.
We're just praying for a healthy baby. We could care less what it calls us, so.
Yeah.
We're
as long
very
as he's
excited.
Wealthy, right?
Yeah, as
yeah,
long as he's wealthy.
I needed to come out being wealthy, very wealthy. So.
Oh, well, we got to take another break, folks. And we have got Tamla Cooper from Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, where their motto is party like a mortician.
That's okay.
Grab
a
cold one.
Okay. There's the line that you cross. All right. Today's show is brought to you by Bannister Cooper Funeral Home. We would love to get your wishes down in writing. You can stop by and visit us next to the McDonald's in Hiawassee, or you can certainly give us a call at 706-896-2218.
This is Tamala Cooper with Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, and I left my husband and staff unattended for a few hours, only to find out I have been given a nickname, which happens to be a rodent. In our line of work, you have to maintain a sense of humor, but I think these guys took it a little far this time. Come by and give them a hard time with me, and while you're there, let's go ahead and get your wishes in writing. Pre-planning your wishes doesn't have to be somber. We are Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, Towns County's local funeral home.
Physical therapy at Erlanger Western Carolina Hospital helps patients return to living and moving pain-free after a physical injury, illness, stroke, or surgery. Now accepting new patients. Call 828-837-7777.
I checked my tires with a penny and I see all of Lincoln's head. And what's up with all of these wires sticking out of the tread? I took a little trip down to Old Blairsville, high up on the hill. Too high country, tire and wheel. Don't let them deflate on the interstate. Call 706-835-1488. High Country Tire is located right up the hill from the post office in Blairsville. They're high on quality and service, but low on prices.
Hello, this is Attorney Richard Sorrell. Do your medical problems prevent you from working? If so, you may be entitled to disability benefits from the Social Security Administration, and I'm here to help you get those benefits. If you or a loved one need help with your disability case, call us at 706-745-5591. We handle disability cases all across the tri-state area, and we're conveniently located in downtown Blairsville. And there's no attorney fee if we don't win your disability case. That's 706-745-5591.
Looking for buying or selling real estate in the mountains? The Rick Andrews Real Estate Team is here to help. Our team of experts will guide you through the real estate process in the Northeast Georgia, Western North Carolina mountains from the moment you inquire until our last meeting. We're here to make buying and selling a rewarding experience. Visit callrickandrews.com to see our listings or call the Rick Andrews Real Estate Team at 828-557-9139. 828-557-9139.
Warmer weather is coming, and that means you've got 50 places to go, and you're still in love with the truck that will get you there. So spring forward with accessories from Rose Auto in Blairsville.
Rose Auto.
Bed covers, towing systems, steps. Rose Auto has what you need to do it right. Just up from 515 on the Murphy Highway. Rose is the only way to get your ride to a ball game, a fishing trip, or an overnight camping trip.
Rose Auto.
Type in Rose Auto Accessories on Facebook. We're next to Mike Seafood.
Regain the ability to perform everyday activities after a debilitating injury or illness. Choose occupational therapy at Erlanger Western Carolina Hospital. Now accepting new patients. Call 828-837-7777.
Pre-planning for your burial or cremation wishes doesn't have to be a downer. Drop into Bannister Cooper Funeral Home for a relaxed and comforting conversation with their team. Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, next to the McDonald's in Hiawassee. We love drop-ins.
All righty, folks, across the teletype machine, we have a proud papa that said True is actually going to be playing April 27th at the car show and then May 4th for the sheriff. So there's two different times you can go by and check the young fella out. Man, like I said, he does good. We've had him on here before, so we got that going. And we were talking before the break just for a minute. You got low-income apartments there beside you built. They're almost done.
No, yeah. What? They are almost done. They are definitely not low-income, though. So they're going to be nice little, there's eight of them.
Yeah. Condos. Are they eight condos?
Yep.
I heard they were going for $1 million apiece.
I have not heard a price, but...
Well, that's a speculation.
Yeah, I mean, they have a boat. They're three stories.
Right.
I think three-bedroom.
Right.
With a car garage and a boat slip on the main highway and the lake. So, they are very, very, very nice.
They are very nice. And that's the kind of growth I like to see.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you.
Is it a private developer?
I think it is a private developer.
Yes, it is a private developer. And I don't think that our county has seen the last of this guy doing some nicer things like that. So.
I'd much rather see that as just the Section 8 housing the guy coming in. Yeah. I mean, honestly. If you got that kind of growth coming in, then that'll explain other growth.
It will. It will. It'll help. He's a nice guy.
Because these folks that spilled $1 million on a house, they want to probably eat, at a nice restaurant, at nice shops, and that kind of brings in all those stuff. But
this is a super nice guy that did the development, and
I don't know, man. If I was rich, I'd be just as cheap as I am now, probably.
Yeah, me too.
I would be too. You hear these folks that win these lottery tickets, and they get millions of dollars, and like 2 years later, they're in jail and broke.
Yeah, I know.
That'd be me.
I wouldn't say I wouldn't be in jail, but I'd still be cheap,
All those million-dollar condos on the lake probably increase all the taxes for anybody that's on 76 Highway. Your valuation will go up.
Yeah, we're working with that. We really are. We have actually got a group of people that is joining together. They're going to start something like, you got the thing that y'all meet on Friday up there and talk about. What is that?
Sundance?
Movers
and Shakers?
Yeah, it's like a group like that. They're starting. That's actually going to be a watchdog for the tax assessors and all that's going on with that. And you might want to get involved in that. I don't know. But,
Do you not think I have enough going on?
Well... But that is in the works. That is definitely in the works because tax stuff is out of control.
So people say, why are you on the DDA? And, why did Mark?
Well, it's because you get that big check every month.
Yeah.
Everybody
Zero,
knows why you're up there.
Nothing. But, if you're not giving back to the community and trying to help steer things in a direction, I don't want to hear you complain when things are not going your way. Be involved.
Well, by God, I'm involved.
Stephen, how do you say that the condos that go in for $1 million are good, and yet you're saying the tax thing is out of control?
Well, we'll get to that. We'll get to that. I'll be like Harry Bond. When I bring in the proof is in the pudding, then you'll say, wow.
When the truth comes out.
I'll explain it to you, Pat, because both of them are government created problems. Mm-hmm. So it's a private person doing this, so it's okay. If the private people want to come in and build a thing, like, that's okay. If the government builds housing, it's going to end badly.
Yeah.
If you have
government building housing.
Oh, we're at Young Harris, Section 8 housing.
Okay, are they getting tax subsidies?
That's a private business.
Are they getting tax subsidies, not. Pat? Tamla's nodding her head. Yes. Then it is a government project. It to whatever extent you want it to be, it is.
Yeah.
How is it not? If they're giving them subsidies, how is it not? If one person gets a tax break, that means somebody has to pick up the slack somewhere.
Does the private builder of those $1 million condos get to deduct things from his income tax?
Tamla's about to say something. Go ahead.
But doesn't he only get to do that like one time?
Yeah. Right. I don't think he's got any kind of government
unless
substitute.
He uses all of it on one time.
And secondly, Pat,
to go over 2 or 3 years.
And secondly, Pat, anytime you have property taxes being taxed on something you already paid taxes on, it's going to end badly. Once again, property taxes are not ethical.
So
here's the thing, Pat. Here's the thing. Let me explain this to you.
I'm just saying you can't.
Hold on a minute, Matt. Hold on a minute.
Hold
on a minute. I am fine with paying taxes as long as everybody's paying the same, because everybody is in the same boat. But I don't like it when there's some that's not and some that is and some that gets charged more and some that don't. I want it level. I want a level playing field, and I'm cool with that.
So you want equity.
I thought you were against fairness equity. Is what I want. Fairness, brother, fairness.
Oh, fairness. And who determines that again?
Well, you would think that the people would, so that's what we're going to do, or not we. I've got
that. Therein lies the problem, because what's fair for you is not fair for me necessarily, or Packy, or Tamala.
Okay, the speed limit's 55, right?
Yeah.
And everybody's supposed to run 55, right?
Right.
And so if some people's allowed to run 95 and not get a ticket, that's not fair, is it?
No, it isn't.
Okay.
You should have tickets.
Hey, we have got to go to a break, folks. But, hey, Dick Mills, man, big shout-out Dick Mills over there. He says that he is selling Plant City, Florida strawberries. Man, that'll be good, man. I'm all about that. Plant City, Florida strawberries, a flat for $10 here at 7M Farm Family Store from 10:30 to 3. All proceeds go to the Dick Mills for State Representative campaign. So y'all can go over and get you. Man, strawberries are already in?
Yeah.
Golly. Do you like strawberries?
In Florida, they are. Huh? In Florida, obviously, well, they are.
Right. I'm coming. I'm coming, Dick. I'm coming. But do you like yours with chocolate on it, or how do you like your strawberries? I mean, you can't just eat them just without chocolate or Cool Whip or...
In milkshakes.
Milkshakes. Now you're talking.
See, Pat likes them in a soy smoothie, probably. Yeah. Right, Pat?
You got to like this guy. Y'all had Dick on. You had Dick Mills on the other day. He seems like a real good guy. Anyway, okay, we have got to get to a break. But wait a minute, I've got a segue. I thought somewhere here. Oh, we're going to let Tamla Cooper take us away, and she says that Packy looks good, like an open casket. Good.
Oh wow, I did not say that, but that was pretty good.
You look like an open casket. Good.
Open
Packy.
Casket. Good. All right, so today's show is brought to you by Bannister Cooper Funeral Home. Lately, we have been a little bit busy, and whenever we're busy, I always seem to find myself with a family who has no idea what their family wants. And so, you know, as I help families that do have pre-planning and how smooth that can go, and they have time to do their grieving, and then when I help a family who's kind of in a tragic situation that has, you know, no idea what was going on, you know, going on with their person or what their wishes were, I always like absolutely see the difference in how well those families are adjusting afterwards. So I encourage you to at least talk with your family about what your wishes are, or come by and let's write them down, or you can give us a call at 706-896-2218. This is Tamala Cooper. A family recently told me that what they love most about our funeral home is that we feel like home and family. I'd like to introduce you to the newest member of our family, Kristen Carvajal.
Come by and meet me. Pick up a calendar and let us answer any questions you might have about funerals, pre-need, or cremations. We are Bannister Cooper Funeral Home, Towns County's local funeral home.
We are located next to McDonald's in Hiawassee, or give us a call 706-896-2218.
When it comes to metalwork in Hayesville, trust TB Fabrications. Our professional welders are your solution for gates, handrails, boat dock repairs, and even pontoon repair. With over a decade of welding experience, we're your reliable choice whether we come to you or you visit our shop. That's right, we are completely mobile and ready to come to your location to make welding repairs to structures, handrails, heavy equipment, gates, you name it. Search TB Fabrications on Facebook or call us at 706-897-8930 today.
Are you dreaming of summer lake days? Find your new boat at the Ridges Marina in Hiawassee. All vessels are 2021 and newer, professionally serviced, and have only been used in fresh water, no salt. We're offering great deals on these used freshwater-only boats. Visit www.georgiaboatsales.com or stop by the Ridges Marina in Hiawassee today. All boats are priced to sell. Trailer package is optional. Get ready to make a splash with your new boat from the Ridges Marina.
Guys, I really feel bad for Daddy that he has to work on all the Saturdays.
Yeah, let's work really, really hard today.
I can do all the faxes.
I could do all the drop-off receipts.
I can do all the copies.
Brandon can take care of the notaries.
What about Josie?
Josie can do the shipping.
Okay, girls, it's 8 o'clock. Let's go.
Wait a minute. I thought you didn't speak English.
Only when I need money from Daddy.
Mountainside Parcel and Post, between the post office and the car wash in Blairsville.
Hey folks, this is Dr. Andre Scheffler. Have you heard the news? Hillcrest Clinic and Imaging has moved. Come visit us at our new facility at 401 Pat Harrelson Drive. Not feeling well? Come see one of our providers at the walk-in clinic. Has your doctor ordered an MRI, CT, ultrasound, or X-ray? Visit our certified radiology center for excellent images at one-third the price of our competitors. You will receive the same high-quality care as before, this time with a flat, easy-to-access parking lot. Come on by. You'll be glad you did.
No matter what the season, Ivy Log Meat Processing in Blairsville is now ready to serve our fellow hunters and farmers in the North Georgia and Tri-State area. Come by Ivy Log for the best beef ribeyes, Wagyu, pork chops, and sausage, along with in-house homemade bacon. 706-745-0011 or visit ivylogmeatprocessing.com. Ivy Log Meat Processing on Facebook, too. 6310 Murphy Highway in Blairsville.
Fridays on the Dish are presented by Bannister Cooper Funeral Home in Hiawassee. The experts at Bannister Cooper will guide you through the important family conversations when it comes to making end-of-life arrangements for a loved one. Yes, we're Towns County's funeral home, but we're welcome to all. And now, back to the Morning Dish.
All righty, we're back with you. I don't know where Melvin, wasn't it Melvin the fact checker that called in? Wasn't it Melvin the fact checker? Who was it?
Melvin.
Melvin. Yeah. He ain't called in a day or two. But anyway, we got a couple of fact checks.
We must be getting everything right.
We got a, no, we don't, because Pat Malone got me in hot water. I mean, I ain't never been so embarrassed in my whole life. But anyway, Pat Malone said that in South Carolina they call grits hominy. And I have a young man that's from South Carolina that called his grandmother, and she called her great-grandmother, and then she called her great-great-grandmother, and she said, that is not correct, that hominy is entirely, completely different from grits. We call grits, grits, you moron.
You embellish the moron part.
Wow.
No, they said moron. He's a moron. He's a moron. Grits are grits.
How do they spell that?
Moron.
M-O-R-O-N.
Moron.
Moron.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah, grits are not. You know, that's the thing about hominy. We're talking about hominy. You really, because you can't get Red Devil Eye anymore, they said. They were talking about that because of all the drugs that's being made or something like that. And it takes the Red Devil Eye to actually get the shell to break loose.
Oh, so, did not know that.
And then Russell said that they give you gas. I never paid no attention to that. I don't know when you try it anyway.
I'm not even sure how we got on this conversation about grits and hominy.
Well, we don't spread false information like the show before us. We like to get the truth out there. And also, we got some more truth that just come across your teletype machine.
Yes. So, just absolutely clearing up any confusion. The condos next to me, he has received no subsidy for those, will not receive any sort of subsidy or benefit. So it is completely private, no government involvement in that. So just so everybody is completely on the up and up on that he is not receiving anything. So those are completely private.
We got that, Pat?
Yeah, like he gets no deductions on his federal income tax.
He doesn't, just like everybody else.
Yeah, just like any other private.
No, not like any other private. I don't get any business deductions. He gets business deductions.
Well, so does everybody else. Anyway, what are we giving away? What are we giving away?
Let's give away some S&S smoothies or the Tin Roof. Either one, your choice.
S&S smoothie or Tin Roof. You got us a question, Pat?
I got a question. What's the longest running primetime TV show?
What is the longest running primetime?
I think I know that one.
I think I do too.
Yeah.
Was it All in the Family?
Something you wouldn't expect.
All in the Family. All in the Family.
Why are you giving possible answers, Steven?
Oh, I'm not. I'm just speculating.
It's a contest.
Okay, 706-379-9770. Give us a call, 706-379-9770. We got you some S&S smoothies or the Tin Roof right here. If you can tell us, what's the longest running TV show?
Ooh,
what else? We got any more comments up
prime
there?
Prime time TV show.
Prime time.
No more comments, but we were talking during the break. Monday, April the 15th, which is also tax day from 6 to 8, the Republican Party is sponsoring a forum for both the sheriff candidates and the court clerk. So all of them are running this year. So a forum is going to be April the 15th at the high school auditorium.
Yep.
From 6 to 8, you can meet the candidates.
And you can actually send questions in somewhere,
can't
you?
You can, and I don't have that information. I will find it out.
If you got a question you want to ask or
yes,
something like that.
You can
and
send
then
it in.
Pat's supposed to. Oh, wait a minute. We got somebody on. Who we got?
We do. We got John Nutt this morning.
Hey, John, you crazy nut. What are you doing?
I'm pouring concrete this morning. How are you guys doing?
How are you pouring concrete and talking on a cell phone all at the same time?
Because I have a headset and I'm a professional.
Oh, okay. There you go.
Talent.
Golly, man, I'll tell you, that's something that we had to do back when we growed up. My daddy built houses, and back then they built them from the ground up. I mean, we dug the footings, poured the concrete all the way. And I remember pouring concrete, and that's something that I don't think I would ever say, dang, I'd like to do this the rest of my life.
Right?
That hard work, man. Golly. So what's the longest running primetime show on, what is it, Pat?
TV.
That's an easy one. It's The Simpsons. They've been on forever.
You're right.
The Simpsons?
That's what I was going to say, yeah.
Yeah.
Longest running animated series, longest running sitcom, and the longest running scripted primetime series in American history.
Do we know how
long? Gotta be 25 years, I'll bet, at this point.
I bet it's more than
that.
Yeah,
probably more than that.
Whatever happened?
Yeah, it might be.
It's 2024, John. It's not 2002 anymore.
Oh, you know? Has it been that long?
Too much concrete for you there, bro.
I got to stop sniffing it, right?
Where are you pouring concrete at?
I'm in 1300 off of the K Road.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're building houses back here, so I'm pouring some footings. I actually drive the truck. I don't have to deal with the heavy concrete.
So who do you drive for?
Southern Concrete.
So, I mean, that 13, how do I get in there? I just like to go in there and look at all them big fancy houses that subsidized, as Pat Malone says, subsidized housing at the 1300.
You probably either got to call the office or call a real estate agent to let you get the code to take you in here. It's a gated community, and only we are allowed in here.
Oh, they just let the concrete guy in?
Yep.
They some pretty houses over, ain't they?
Yes, they have some very nice places.
What? That's more of that low-income housing there, low-income housing at the 1300.
Yes, low-income for millionaires.
There you go. There you go. That's just a weekend getaway. All right, man, we got you.
I got it up here for you, John.
Thank you, sir.
Got a comment come across here just for you, Pat. 1 minute you say you are for smaller gov. Next minute you say you are for bigger government. You are wishy-washy. Where do you draw the line? You can't pick and choose, Pat. I can't read the last
part.
Where
did I say I was for bigger government?
Something about wiping something off of your nose. I'm gonna read it.
He's solid.
Where do you
again.
Say what, Pat? Sorry.
I'm trying to figure out where I said I was for bigger government.
Well, I think it came in, we were talking about with the housing.
Yeah, low-income housing.
Government doing stuff for the housing.
Did I say anything about being big government?
Are you back to drinking again? You sound like you're back to drinking again. You can't even remember what we talked about.
No, I'm not back to drinking yet.
How much longer you got?
I don't know. How much longer are you gonna abuse me?
We ain't abusing you, Pat. We're trying to educate our listeners.
Yeah. You call it education, I call it indoctrination.
Oh, indoctrination. I don't know, yeah. Man. It's a crazy world we live in. But, hey, the eclipse is coming and the end is soon.
Yeah.
I mean, they could do the whole CERN thing on a different day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, do they have to do it on that day?
I guess they do.
Do they have to find the God particle on that day?
Yeah. Kind of weird, ain't it? Yeah, kind of weird. But anyway, we got the weekend.
Could move the eclipse, right?
School.
That could move the eclipse.
I mean, I don't know why they do it on a weekday when people are at work and in school. Why don't they do it on the weekend?
I'm with you. That's like they got deer crossings. They have them very heavy travel roads. They ought to move them, you'd think.
Yeah. Let the deer cross somewhere else. Yeah.
Yeah. Anything else going on this weekend? I don't know. I'm kind of out of the loop.
I got to work.
Hey, the big blood drive is going on at the Civic Center in Blairsville for the Derek Whittle Memorial semi-annual blood drive.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Think they'll do that. That'd be good. I reckon school's out next week at Towns County for spring break, or I guess it'd be spring break, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Spring break.
And they got teachers work day to day, so.
Yep. All the little kids are home.
I get to sleep late.
When do you go on vacation, Pat? I thought you were out last
week. Are you kidding? He's retired. He's on vacation all the time.
You sent us a text that I'm going out of town or something. And then
this Wednesday.
Wednesday? Oh, it's funny.
It's coming Wednesday.
I'm going to see if I get get Gary to move to Tuesday.
No. I did Wednesdays on purpose. I need a respite.
Hey, we got some breaking news, too. We got somebody going to start joining our show on a regular basis.
Yeah, so we actually, I'm setting that up. I think it's going to start on Friday, Pat. We got Andrew Clyde going to be every other Friday is going to be on our show.
Good.
Yeah, yeah, so if that's okay with you, I know he's a little conservative, so.
Yeah.
I'll be off on every other Friday.
That's okay. Nice.
All right, and I'm working on Marjorie Taylor Greene, so.
Yeah. Good job, bud.
Okay.
Oh. Everybody looks confused all of a sudden.
Now we're not going to put him on there. We already talked about that.
So now you look at me like, what? I have no idea.
All right. Yep. The beeper button's not working, apparently.
Yeah.
Huh?
So now next week, y'all got more of these contestants coming on for the run. I mean, y'all hadn't got everybody on yet, have you? I mean, you still got some.
No, we haven't got everybody on. We got Jana Akins, who's running for Union County School Board. Is one of our guests next week. And let's see, who else? I forget the other one that's in there. There's two candidates for next week.
Right.
For the school board?
No, let's see. Wait, hang on a minute. I'm getting there. There's Eric Barrett, who's running for the Towns County Clerk of Court, is on Thursday, and Jana's on Tuesday.
Okay, that's all you got?
Well, yeah, and I think we're one person away from finishing up, and that's going to happen the following week, I think.
Where are y'all going to do the debate?
The debate start on May 1st,
okay.
May 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, and then 6th, 7th, and 8th.
All right, folks, we'll be back with you. Georgia Mountain Grading, we want to thank Georgia Mountain Grading. They have... been a long-time supporter, and we appreciate them. They are family-owned and operated, so if you need any kind of driveway, any kind of grading whatsoever,
anything
call them.
Buried.
Yeah, anything buried, Tamla. Yeah. And if you're feeling weak and you want to go down easy, call Tamla at Bannister Cooper Funeral Home.
249 DBNW JULAM, Hiawassee.
Well, looka here. Guess who's number one in the Nielsen ratings again?
Hey, 97.7!